Now, from Hollywood, romance.
Spending the spring of the year in Portugal was something I'd always thought of as idyllic. And it was, until a friend of mine named Breck Michener ran into a startling little package with the unlikely name of Crystal Fenway.
So now, with High Everback as Breck and Gene Bates as Crystal, we bring you transcribed Kathleen Hite's delightful comedy, Development in Portugal.
Let me put it this way. I've been almost everywhere. I've seen almost everything. But this development in Portugal was the clincher. Well, I figure as the one to tell this story because it didn't happen to me. If it had, I wouldn't believe it. I'd figure someone had sprayed me with dream stuff or slipped me a loaded pipe. But I know it's true because I watched it happen. Now get this picture. The International Airport in Lisbon. Daytime. This is the bar. And not too big a crowd on hand, so it isn't too tough to spot the two jokers sitting at the far end of the bar. The blonde guy with the tan suit and the gray expression is Breck Michener, the photographer. The tight little wads of paper to one side of him are cablegrams that he's written and discarded. And I'm the little tight wad on the other side of him wrapped around the national drink. Oh, my name's Harper, Nate Harper. Sometimes writer, sometimes nothing. Another cablegram bit the dust. Well, come on, you might as well move in on this. This is how it started.
What's the dirtiest word you can put in a cable?
Collect?
Oh, you're a big help.
What's so tough about it? All you want to do is quit, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'd like to make it sound like an international incident. Now, what makes that jerk Harris think he can do this to me?
Oh, some stupid reason, like he's your boss.
Well, not if I quit, he isn't.
So quit.
I can't afford to.
So don't quit. Plane due at 10:30?
Hmm?
I say, is the plane due at 10:30?
Yeah.
We've got 2 minutes.
Oh, damn reporter. Why don't they just fire me? How come the torture treatment? Sending a dame over here from the New York office. I covered the stupid jewel story when it broke. What's this doll coming over for anyway? To check my spelling?
The ways of a bureau chief are strange. Maybe Harris has snapped his cap. Maybe Hurricane Hazel got him. Maybe this dame's got him. What's her name again?
You ready?
Go.
Crystal Fenway.
Sounds fictitious.
I hope she is. You know, the last female correspondent I worked with drank me under the table, cleaned me at poker, and smoked small cigars.
Well, that's only type A. Do you ever work with type B?
Well, I don't know. What's that like?
A big girl, usually. Sleek. Upper. She's pals with the international set. Type B is amusing herself. She dabbles in writing. Amazes her friends by dashing off a couple of couplets and one poem of pure iambic pentameter per year.
Yeah, well, either way, I'm dead.
Hey, $5 says she's type B.
You're on. I'm a cinch for type A.
Your ascension, please. International Airways, flight 21 from New York. Now landing on International Concourse number 1.
Farewell, old friend.
Oh, shut up.
International Airways, flight 21 from New York. Now landing on International Concourse number 1.
Just the stragglers were at customs by the time we got there, among them a type A and a type B. Turns out neither was Crystal Fenway. The late morning Lisbon sun was too bright for a couple of guys who spent the morning storing up raw courage, and we blinked our way back inside to International Airways desk.
That's right, sir. Miss Crystal Fenway was a passenger on flight 21.
Are you sure she landed?
Well, she must have. She took off with a flight from New York. You see the check by her name?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I see.
Everyone else landed.
This doll may have a stubborn streak.
She could have been dropped at sea.
Excuse me, please. Miss Crystal...
Charming fellow.
Yeah, very nice.
Oh, you did? I see. That's all I want to know. Yeah. I understand from the other clerk that you and Miss Fenway left the airport immediately after costumes in the company of a gentleman.
She did, huh? Well, that's just great.
So you see, she did land.
Yeah, I see.
Miss Fenway was not at the hotel when we got there. Breck left word at the desk to call his room if and when she did arrive. And I was really beginning to feel sorry for the guy. If Crystal showed up, he'd have to deal with a dame reporter, and if she didn't, he'd have to deal with Harris. Well, this amounts to no deal at all. It's like not having your cake and not eating it. I myself sacked out at this point. I woke up in the early evening to a note from Breck saying that Crystal was for real, and he'd gone to her room.
Yes? Oh, you must be Mr. Michener.
I must be.
Well, I guess you know I'm Crystal Fenway, and... Oh, please, come in.
Thanks.
Mr. Michener, may I present Monsieur Dupour?
Hello, Dupour.
Merci.
Oh, there now. Oh, do sit down, Mr. Michener.
Well, I don't want to break anything up. I could come back
now,
later.
Now, you sit right down.
No. I must be going. We have had our little time together for now, mademoiselle.
We certainly have. I just don't know how to thank you for all the many, many, well, just memorable experiences.
Oh, my extreme pleasure, mademoiselle. And we shall have many more. Is it not?
Oh, it is. It most certainly is.
Eh bien, au revoir, mademoiselle. Oh, monsieur.
Bye.
And again, au revoir.
Goodbye. Well, now, where were we?
Nowhere.
You know, I wouldn't blame you, Mr. Michener, if you were a little bit upset with
me. I've never been a little bit upset in my life.
Oh, now, you're just being nice. You know very well that Monsieur Dupour and I ran off from you at the airport. And, well, you're nice to be nice about it.
You sure you're a reporter?
Well, indeed I am. I got the dandiest little nose for news you ever saw.
Type C yet.
Hmm?
Oh, nothing. It's a local joke. About this story on the jewels.
Oh, my goodness. I almost forgot about them.
Just a natural-born news hound, huh?
Oh, I'll have to admit it. My mind just isn't on business today, Mr. Michener. You see, Monsieur Dupour sat next to me on the plane, and we had the nicest sort of visit coming over. So naturally, when we landed here in Lisbon, we were fast friends.
Well, why not?
Well, that's exactly the way I looked at it. So when Monsieur Dupour just insisted, well, it seemed like a wonderful chance.
Look, Miss Fenway,
So I went sightseeing with him.
Oh.
We saw the Roman columns, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And parts of the old wall of D. Alfonso Enrique.
Yeah, pretty.
And then several Manueline doorways.
They're nice.
Monsieur Dupour pointed out his hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see.
Miss Fenway?
Yes, Mr. Michener.
Do you ever eat?
Yes, Mr. Michener.
Miss Fenway, let's eat.
From my vantage point at the hotel bar, I caught their entrance into the dining room. My first look told me that my $5 bet was safe. She was no type A. My second look told me that no money would change hands at all. Crystal Fenway was middle 20s on the plain side. I had the feeling she might be sort of pretty if she tried. So far, though, I guess she hadn't tried.
Now, Miss Fenway, how long have you been a reporter?
About 48 hours.
That long?
Mr. Harris was just wonderful about it. Mind if I tell you how it happened?
I insist that you tell me.
Well, 5 years ago, when I graduated from college, I marched my journalism degree straight to the New York Star and demanded a job as a cub reporter. And I've been in the morgue ever since.
Well, what sprung you after 5 years?
The discovery of those jewels and all those art treasures over here. When I explained to Mr. Harris that I'd studied extensively about Portuguese art and showed him my old school papers on the subject of many of these very jewels, he agreed to send me over to do a series of feature articles on them for the Star Sunday magazine.
Well, I don't know. Bunch of construction workers dig up a few tired old gems, and Harris wants Sunday features on it. What's so big?
Oh, Mr. Michener, it's a very big story. Well, many of the jewels have been missing since the great earthquake and tidal wave of the middle 18th century.
No.
Well, some go as far back as the reign of Alfonso I. I can hardly wait to see them.
Oh, well, your press card will admit you to the museum and permit you to a quick look under the steady gaze of the guards. I couldn't even get a picture. They're so nervous about them.
Oh, I think they'll permit you to take a few shots once I explain to them just who we are and all that.
Well, yeah, you handle that for me, will you? Well, good night, Miss Fenway.
Oh, please. Won't you come in for just a little while?
Well, we'll be starting out to see the jewel collection pretty early.
I have a wonderful view from my balcony, Mr. Michener. Monsieur Dupour and I saw it by day, and I'm so anxious to see it by night.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, well, thank you, Mr. Michener. Oh, my God.
What?
I can see part of the lights from here. Oh, Mr. Michener, hurry. It's breathtaking.
Yeah, it is. It's beautiful.
It's almost too much. I mean, being in a foreign land and all this beauty and a balcony. Mr. Michener.
Yes, Miss Fenway?
I think you ought to know. I'm going to kiss you right now. Thank you, Mr. Michener.
Thank you, Miss Fenway.
We will return to romance and our story, Development in Portugal, in just a moment. Music from the new Broadway production of Peter Pan and from Showboat, and plenty of surprise guests from show business. They'll be excitingly yours tomorrow when Mike Wallace brings us his latest on a Sunday afternoon show. Music, song, and pleasure for the whole family, coming, going, or staying at home. Remember, CBS Radio's on a Sunday afternoon, 2 hours of it, tomorrow and every Sunday on most of these same stations. And now for the second act of Romance.
I can't be sure of this, but it's a safe bet that my friend Breck slept not at all that night. All I know is how he looked the next morning. Like shell shock. There were blank stares, which he augmented here and there by slowly shaking his head from side to side as if something had happened that he didn't believe.
I think I'll take a cold shower.
You just took one.
Yeah, well, I think I'll take another one.
Out late?
Oh, safe in my room at 10.
You feel all right?
She kissed me.
Crystal?
Miss Fenway, she kissed me.
You get her for stamp collecting.
All of a sudden, she just turned to me on the balcony. She said, Mr. Michener, I think you ought to know I'm going to kiss you right now. And she did. What kind of a crack is that? Stamp collecting. You don't know about Miss Fenway. I don't even think Miss Fenway knows about Miss Fenway.
Brag boy, look.
Look, if she were a raving beauty, a real queen, but she isn't. Miss Fenway is nothing in the world
except a mass of hidden talent.
I think I'll take a cold shower.
Do you know anyone named DePore?
I don't even know Crystal Fenway.
Yeah, I'm sure I've seen this guy before. Hey, what's that? What's that?
Try the door.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Mitchell?
Yes?
Parcel for you, sir.
Thank you. Well, I'll be... Hey, Nate. Look.
Flowers?
Yeah.
Here, I'll get the card for you. This is, Mr. Michener, I hope you'll forgive me for being so forward last night. Signed, Fenway.
Let me see that. Oh, come on. That's not so funny.
I took that cold shower a little inadvertently, I'll admit. I was shoved into it by a shell-shocked friend. I understand that Miss Fenway was quiet as a mouse on the way to the museum. And Breck was pretty stony himself until he remembered to thank her for the flowers.
I'm glad you like the flowers, Mr. Michener. I didn't know how else to tell you how ashamed I am.
Well, it's nothing to be ashamed of.
I don't know what got into me. I only hope I didn't give you a wrong impression.
Believe me, there was nothing wrong with that impression.
Well, thank you, Mr. Michener.
Like I said, thank you, Miss Fenway.
Why are you stopping the car?
Steady, Miss Fenway. This is a museum.
Oh. Oh.
Allow me? Have you got your press card?
Oh, yes. Yes, indeed.
Well, let's go.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Monsieur DePore, how nice. I was afraid you couldn't make it.
I found at the very last minute I could rearrange my plan. Bonjour, monsieur.
Hi.
Monsieur DePore wouldn't believe me on the plane when I told him those jewels alone were valued at several million dollars.
Oui, incroyable.
I told him just to come along and see for himself.
You carry a press card, DePore?
No, nothing like that.
You better have something like that or they won't let you in.
Oh, but I am no one.
You certainly are someone. And you're going right in with us. You are my friend, and
You'll tell it to the museum director.
Here! No one is permitted inside the museum without the proper identification.
Oh, yes, well, I'm Crystal Fenway of the New York Star. This is my photographer, Mr. Michener.
Your card is in order, Miss Fenway. Yours, please, Mr. Michener.
I've been here before.
I have no memory for faces. But your card is in order. Very well. This gentleman?
What? Oh, no, I am no one.
You mustn't be so sensitive, Monsieur DePore. He's my friend. I can vouch for him.
Oh, but this is not enough, Miss Fenway. Without accredited identification, I'm afraid I cannot admit the gentleman.
My dear sir, if you want the New York Star to cover this story, as it should be covered, with pictures and all...
We permit no pictures, Miss Fenway.
Oh, my goodness, you're impossible.
Please, mademoiselle, I am not worth this trouble to you.
Monsieur DePore, there is such a thing as freedom of the press. I intend to see that principle applied. Now then, the New York Star...
Miss Fenway, our little museum is not impressed by the New York Star. I am sorry. We are not interested in any more press notoriety than we have already had. Now, if you will please go, before I have to call the guards.
What? You'll hear from my paper on this. And we'll be back here to get the story and pictures.
Miss Crystal Fenway really went to work. And she put Breck to work, too. Anywhere she could track down bits of history on the guarded art treasures. Breck took pictures, Crystal compiled her notes, and Monsieur DePore went along for the ride. My friend Breck began to show signs of wear. Another thing.
I know I've got one somewhere.
You take all these shots for the doll story?
No, not these. These are old ones. I'm looking for a picture of DePore.
You got one?
The more I look at that kisser, the more I know I shot him once. Yeah, I can't figure what she sees in him.
Have you figured what you see in her?
Yeah, not yet. Hey, this is it. Rome, 1940. Holy jumping. Wow.
Let's see. DePore?
Yeah. Only the name's really Lascelles, one of the Jim Dandiest international jewel thieves you ever saw.
Miss Fenway and her hidden talent.
Miss Fenway's room, and hurry. She's what? Yeah, this is Michener, Oh, fine. Oh, real fine.
Well?
She left a message for me in case I called. She's gone to the museum with us to sell. Laporte, the guy.
We galvanized into action. Breck, camera in hand at the museum, me to alert the law. Now, I myself had no trouble getting my point across, but my friend Breck hit a real snag.
Look, I must have left my press card at the hotel, but remember me? I'm Michener, New York star.
Michener? Oh, but that cannot be. Mr. Michener is inside with Miss Fenway.
Oh, that crazy dame. She took my press card.
Please, I hear so many stories.
Well, listen to another one. That guy with Miss Fenway is only LaSalle's boy jewel thief, and he's probably stolen you blind by now.
Really, sir? I'm busy.
I'm going through.
Now, see here now.
Hey! Marine, have landed.
Delegation de police. The police? You mean he's really... Oh, hurry! This way!
We finished in a dead heat, and what we saw stopped us all cold. Miss Fenway viewed us calmly and indicated her chum Dupour, firmly established between two of the guards. She seemed only quietly triumphant, and for the first time I noticed, she had quite a nice smile.
You know, Mr. Michener, I really believe we have ourselves a scoop. Such a beautiful city, Lisbon. And so very magic by night.
You knew who Dupour was all along?
It just began to dawn on me the last few days.
Uh-huh.
You see, Mr. Michener, as a general rule, men are not attracted to me. Not even older men, like Monsieur Dupour.
They aren't, huh?
Not as a general rule. When Monsieur Dupour showed signs of such constant devotion, I decided he must have a reason.
Yeah, a guy could have a reason.
That's what I thought. So while you were out taking pictures a couple of days ago, I just stepped into your rooms and checked your file. And there he was. I'm used to the files. 5 years in the morgue, you know.
Well, you're, not in the morgue now.
No. I'm not.
Miss Fenway.
Yes, Mr. Michener.
I think you ought to know. I'm going to kiss you. Right now. Thank you, Miss Fenway.
Oh. Thank you, Mr. Michener.
Romance is produced and directed by Norman McDonald, with editorial supervision by Hep Mannheim. You have heard Development in Portugal, specially written for Romance by Kathleen Height, starring Hy Averback as Breck and Jean Bates as Crystal. The narrator was Harry Bartell. Featured in the cast were Ben Wright, Nestor Paiva, and Fritz Feld. This is Hugh Douglas inviting you to hear Romance, transcribed next week at this same time. Tomorrow night, the Radio Hall of Fame, with Lionel Barrymore as host, dramatizes the story of James Cook, Explorer. It's the fascinating true account of exploration that led the outside world to the Hawaiian Islands and the personal story of the man responsible. Don't forget, CBS Radio presents the Radio Hall of Fame tomorrow night over most of these same stations. The drama, James Cook, Explorer.
This is the CBS Radio Network.